Hello everyone, my name is Sara Angels. I am an astronomer by training, but I have been working in science communication and science education for several years, mainly with NUCLEO. I am also doing PhD research jointly at Leiden University and University of Minho, focusing on science literacy as an interface between science communication and science education. Today we will present the results of an article that is about to be published in a JCOM special issue, hopefully this month. The article focuses on communities of practice in science communication and how they can make important contributions to public engagement with science, but are under-researched. All of us here are aware that science communicators are key actors for making connections between the fields of science and society at large. Science communicators want to make science understandable, appealing, approachable. Practitioners may take up different roles. They can be scientists, informal science educators, press officers, science journalists, bloggers, etc. It is often the case that science communicators organize themselves into communities of practice that are networks of knowledge sharing with a common goal, the wish to improve communication practices. Several studies focused on scientists' participation in science communication. However, research that focused on the roles of communities of practice is scarce, which means the contribution of these groups to the science-society relationship has been overlooked. Aside from this, there seems to be a certain distance between the practice of science communication and the academic research on science communication. On the one hand, research is very normative and often neglects practitioners' reflections and knowledge. And on the other hand, science communication research is seen as of little use for practitioners. There is evidence that when collaboration between research and practice in science communication occurs, that multiple benefits are achieved. So today we wish to offer contributions to start filling these gaps, the lack of knowledge transfer between theory and practice, and the gap concerning research on science communication practitioners themselves. In this presentation, we will be looking at the perspectives of a specific community of practice, the astronomy communication community. There is something that you should be aware by now, and that's why we picked up this CAP 2018 group photo. What we intended with this study is to do a snapshot of the community at a given moment. Since communities are by nature organic, dynamic structures, by observing them, we do not expect to find unique ways of acting in the face of diverse contexts of relationship with science. However, trends, ways of seeing, and common practices can be observed that are worth highlighting to help the community in self-critical reflection. So what have we done? We took advantage of the 2018 CAP conference, where a good portion of the community gathered in Japan to look at the perceptions, practices, and concerns of the astronomy communication community, especially with regard to how astronomy communication practitioners conceive their audiences, what kind of public engagement they seek, and how they appropriate science communication research in their practices. In looking at communities or practice, we use a participant observation approach. Then we conducted a set of interviews for the selection of respondents. We first identified 10 community active members. The remaining interviewees were selected considering age, career stage, function, geographical location, and the type of audience to which they address their practices. The interviews were anonymous. In addition, we use other data sources, namely document analysis and a field diary. Although we acknowledge that communities are a variety and formed by individuals with different profiles, we realize that certain ideas and perspectives keep appearing recurrently in the interviews. This table presents our research goals regarding the interviews, which lead us to led us to three main themes: the public, the community's concerns regarding public engagement, and practices for engagement. What have we found? We found that the community considers that the public is emotionally connected to astronomy. Astronomy offers majestical pictures, addresses the big questions: are we alone? Where are you going? Where are we going? Where do we come from? And there is some magic and romance in the stars and planets we wish upon a star. The public is seen, therefore, emotionally connected to astronomy, which can be a powerful hook to trigger interest for science in general and for STEM in particular. Despite that, the public lacks knowledge and has several misconceptions, stereotypes about science and scientists. Science is difficult, it's only for special people. Some refer to gender-related stereotypes, others to racial, ethnic, disability, or socioeconomic conditions. Several interviewees recognize that public support is essential to influence science policies, especially science funding. However, we found no considerations in the interviews that will lead us to think that, in their opinion, the public should be a participant in the governance of science, even in the speech of practitioners based in Europe, where there is a substantial investment in programs such as Science With and For Society, which is based on democratic ideals. Public engagement, understood as participation in policy, seems to remain confined to discourses in politics and academia, with the astronomy communication community paying little attention to the public in policy making. Astronomy communicators see themselves as facilitators between science and the public, with the tools and methodologies to bring science to the public being planned in a way that matches people's interests and expectations. Practitioners offered clues to multiple goals for engaging the public with astronomy, as you can see here. Interviewers pointed various types of concerns relevant to their public engagement practices. They concern scientists at school, STEM careers, the gender gap, and the media. The community regularly shares experiences as a means for identifying, monitoring, and enhancing good practices. Our observation of the conference, where most presentations focused on members' do's and don'ts, reinforced this idea. Analysis of the proceedings book reference section showed many links to organizations and project websites, but rather few to academic publications. This confirms that academic research has little to no weight on the community's practice and should be prompt further study to explain the motives behind this fact. Concluding, the community of practice recognizes multiple goals for public engagement, many of which are critical to scientific citizenship. It seems that astronomy communicators are still discovering different forms are relating to their audiences. The notion that astronomy communication tend to hold of their audiences limits the relationship they build with the publics of science. The public is mostly seen as having a single role, a recipient of science information, except concerning science policies, which practitioners admit the public may influence. Media and school are sources of misconceptions and stereotypes, so practitioners want to work closely with them. There is also a limited influence of science communication research on the community. The astronomy communication community needs to be prepared to face growing challenges regarding an open and democratic view of science governance. So we think that there is an additional training that is needed on science communication research. As most practitioners have formal training on science, they need to widening collaborations and partnerships with other science communication stakeholders. Needless to say that bridging the gap between science communication research and practices, we want to help lower some of these barriers and gaps. So supporting the community in developing process of reflexive practice was the idea with this article and this study. Thank you very much.